song inside.
Well, actually, 9.5 months have been gone. I'm starting my 10th month of being here, so that's only 3 more to go. It's a 1-year program. Actually, to lead off what Mr. Bitchler was saying, it was about a year ago, and I had after a youth group band come home, and I had the thought of doing some type of ministry, becoming a youth pastor, whatnot. And I was oh, this is great. And then I talked to Seth about it, and I was just like, no. Then it kind of went away. But then a couple months later, I think it was 3 or 4 months later, all of a sudden my mom told me about this program, I'm reading a book, and I was just like, oh, I guess so. I mean, I looked at it, why not, you know? I feel like God was covovering my eyes to all the extra things that were entitled in this program that I kind of had no clue about. And God could do really anything. And I was just working at B-dubs and kind of not doing anything. And all of a sudden I'm 900 miles south of Louisiana working on a ship. And God could do anything if you're willing. Anything.
Amen.
And also, I have some slideshow pictures to really help explain things. And I'll talk about other things, too. So you want to give a...
That's, go to the video.
Video.
That one always plays people.
Exactly what it's like, but that was the first year it was ever created, and that's they had 60 people come in, and it was a massive amount, but now it's growing down. But yes,
better.
This is the spirit that we live on. This is probably, it was docked in Galveston, Texas, years back. But I mean, this is where it all started, and before I go on in my talking, if anyone it's a ministry. It's called Friendships, and it's all volunteer, and it's If any of you are looking to get into some type of volunteer, or you just kind of want to, your life's not moving anywhere, or you want to go and serve God in a crazy way, and just leave all you know and just go somewhere, well, they will house you and feed you. And that's honestly all you need.
Amen.
I'm being they have that. This is a... just put on the Facebook there, we're requesting crew members or anybody that wants to come in, and you can come in and you can stay there a day, you can stay there a lifetime. But it's really interesting what God can do to that. Want to stay there a day, you learn, you work with everyone, or you're a Seahawk and you work there all the time, and you're there 24/7. God can just, God uses people that serve, and by serving, it's just this, I get this feeling after I serve, help someone, it's like, just the best thing. It's better to give than to get.
Amen.
And I mean, that's the Christmas season kind of thing. Like, I don't really need anything, but, you know, it's nice to get things, but I got everything I need. I got my family, and I'm home, and it's like, that was good. So I got the clicker.
Yeah, it's not working.
There we go.
Now we got it. That is a better picture of the Spirit.
Yeah. Amen.
This is a 1965 World War II cargo battleship. Modified, of course. And we live on this thing. It's stationary. It just stays there. It's really old. And I mean, it's a beautiful ship. I live like right back there. Small air conditioning. So nice during Louisiana summers. I tell you. Holy cow. Me and Bradley during a boot camp setting, which just goes down the phase of what you do at boot camp. I did not know. In friendships, as being a Seahawk, you do crazy amounts of volunteer activities. This was one, we did dragon boat racing. We helped out. They needed people, and we'd go over there, and we just sitting there and say, yes, sir, no, sir, yes, ma'am, of that kind of sorts. And that's the way we've been trained to act like ready. Someone needs something, it's, yes, sir, you go over there and you do it. And then people see that. They see the difference in you from someone else. And that's why the Seahawks is like an elite force that just makes that, it's an upgrade from normal volunteers' works that, you know, they might work a couple hours. We're there from beginning to end, every day, and that's brutal. We do a lot of, we help out with setups and the teardowns of concerts. Like, a lot, I've been to at least 10 Christian concerts, like the major people, and we're there doing security and teardown of all the stage equipment. I mean, we're just, it's really fun because you get to see, I mean, obviously a crowd, or obviously Family Force 5, 10, 5th Avenue North, and just like a whole bunch of bands, and, which is awesome because you get it for free. You're either working right next to the stage or just get to meet the bands there. So that's one plus of being a missionary that works there. All right, this the Seahawks is a military-style missionary group in which we all wear, I mean, I'm wearing my work BDUs right now, as you can tell. Normally they're clean, they're inspection BDUs. And, this is our group for the most part a couple months back, but holy cow. Fun times doing stuff. I'll go back one. As we say, we do a lot of volunteer activities, and this time we went to a church that needed our help, and we helped them like build like half the church within a certain amount of time frame that we could have. You know, we could work for like 6 hours, and we just, I remember us, because we were still in boot camp, we were laying this patio out with bricks, and that was ever so annoying, because there was a flood there, we had to get everything in, but as boot campers, that is your job. You're nothing when you're in boot camp. Also, I did not know that I was going into a crazy fitness missionary work. which entitled Lots and Lots of PT, Physical Training. I mean, that's called a field, and it is death. You could think of the hottest summer here, probably about like 90, maybe. Think Louisiana, 100% humidity, probably like 115 on the field, and just death. We're doing bear crawls. That's called the baseline. Holy cow. We learned to do push-ups and get really good at that. Also, during the stay, you learn a lot of skills of being, as a SEAC, you'll learn right off the bat, you'll learn self-discipline for sure, obedience, and respect towards authority. That is, and we have a line of command goes, boot campers, Seahawks, corporals, sergeants, staff sergeant, sergeant major, and then a commander. We have that set up there, so it's a yes sir, no sir, all the time. There's no back talk or no butt. Or they'll end up in a disciplinary action known as a gig. I'll give you a brief explanation of what the gig is, because it makes it a lot easier. Gig is boot camp week number one, it's a 12-week program, is 10 push-ups, 10 flutter kicks, or 10 squats. And as you can assume, goes up by week. And it has a constant 100 push-ups, flutter kicks, and squats. And those are just one way is to motivate you to do something. And let's say I got a lot the first couple weeks, and then I did not want to do any more. A lot of this is PT in boot camp. Learn how to shine your shoes correctly, your boots. These were shined pretty nicely, but kind of worked in them. But you learn how to shine your shoes, iron your clothes, look good, shave and clean. I've grown a little thing because I haven't grown anything in a while, so why not? But as learning at boot camp, you are stripped away of everything from life. Like, you are stripped away from the outside world completely. No phones, no electronics, no TV, no city clothes of any kind at all, no sugar. You are just bound to your Bible, the port, and church. And they make it to the program to where you have to rely on God, or you will fail and quit. I mean, we started out with 7, and now we have 4. And that was in the first week, one quit, another quit, like a couple weeks later. I mean, it's doing God's work is easy, you know, but other kind of God's work is really hard. You learn to really dig deep into your Bible and actually study. I mean, sure, you're pretty tired at 5 in the morning trying to read your Bible and then go work out. So that was the 3 months of just torture. But yes. Also, did lots and lots of outreaches to the community. We lived in the bad side of town. We lived on the south side, over the train tracks. So we lived in the ghetto, I mean, of Lake Charles. And it's mostly a black community, and a lot of poverty in the projects. And we are able to, when we have a surplus of food that comes in, we like to go out into the community and play with the kids, pray with people. I mean, that's one of the reasons why we do it. So we pray with people and actually show God's love to people. And that's if you ever get an opportunity to serve and do that, I can give you this food, but I'd also want to pray with you. That's I could feed you and all, but what's the point? I'm just fattening them up to send them to hell. So that's one of the big. That's the main thing behind it. I mean, honestly, that's what's the point then? Oh boy, you can see me. Just say we all lost a lot of weight. I lost 25 pounds. This guy right here. That guy. Man, he lost about 50 pounds. Oh boy. Yeah. Oh. Interesting fact here. This lady is called Grandma Gwen. She is 93 years old. She lives on port. And she's the first woman race car driver. Which is really cool, I guess. And she still drives. She's so cute. She's like waves, and her voice is so high, and she's so cute, and she's scary at the same time. You're on the highway. Oh boy, sweet old lady. Yeah. 1 week we got to do a missions week where we're in mission mode and get out of bed, and they're like knocking the door, come down the frying pan. We're all there. I'm like, okay, you guys got 30 minutes to pack up all your gear. And head out to the front. So we had a week long of just mission trips. We got a whole bunch of MREs and sticking in our pockets. We're munching on those. Anybody have an MRE before? I mean, they're good for the first part, yeah. And then after a couple days, I mean, they're just nice and bland. And we had like this civilian one, so they weren't the actually good ones with all the flavors, all the different brands. But we have a lot of donated MREs that are really expired, but they're still good. I mean, we have a semi-truck full of just MREs and boxes. I have leftovers in my closet back home. Snack on. But if you go back to that picture, I gave a quick demonstration. This is what it's supposed to look like when we get everything set up. We didn't put up the containers and all, but that is the full on when we go to the different countries for the medical missions. And that's why they have us Seahawks to do all the heavy lifting, because that's why they created the Seahawk program, because there's a whole bunch of older crew people that could do all the smart stuff. But couldn't do all the heavy lifting and grunt work, so they made the Seahawk program into all the 18 to 25 year olds. So that's when you're prime. You can really lift weights and take stuff like that. But yeah, that's what it's supposed to look like, for the most part. This is very important. These are the two people that started Friendships Ministry back in 1985. Miss Sandra and Mr. Don Tipton. They started this from the beginning. They have a book out called Jesus and Company, Part 1, which is Part 2, be a Part 3 soon. But it tells about their life and how God, he was a polo club owner in California making big bucks. And God was just like, hey, I want you to go and work in the ships ministry. And he was obedient to God, and he left like a rich, rich life and left to be a poor missionary that had the first picture of the ship. I mean, well, it did not look like that, though. Really bad looking. And they gave him that, and they started going and working on that. And now they have, back and forth, five ocean-going vessels, 10 sailboats, and just a huge property, and how you start off from nothing, and now how God uses that really expands you when you give. So, I mean, they are great people. Nope. Back to that one. Nope.
Give me a second.
Does this work?
No, it doesn't.
All right, yeah, get back to that Jerusalem call. The Jerusalem call. If no one heard, we had the Jerusalem call, which is the Jerusalem call. So this is where we had a whole bunch of senators And we had the, Ron Ichishi from Israel, the ambassador of Israel, come and talk about what's going on in Israel. And it was a big support of what's going on in Israel, and to really focus you what's going on and to inform you how to vote for Israel. And there's a whole bunch of senators there pro-Israel, and that was a, we were working it, so we were tired, but really informative. And the Bible is really, God is really strong about Israel's people, so it kind of clicked in my head a bit more. I never really thought of it that way. It says Israel a lot in the Bible. It's just, but they're big. This ministry is big on Israel and support of Israel in Jerusalem. And, that's the ambassador of Israel
right there.
So that was, cool to have someone from actually from Israel, like the right-hand man of the president, come down and talk in this. All right, next one. Those are my Seahawk bros. In this one, we went to Missouri for 2 weeks to help out a camp in Camp Niwi. And it's autistic and, other kids camp that they had flooding done, and we had to do all the landscaping and just cut everything by hand and do all that stuff. That's where the MREs were, big trailers full of MREs, and those were three times a day eating those. Which one you got? Got some spaghetti. I got chicken and noodles. You want that? No, I got that for dinner. Just that kind of dealio. But we did get to eat some real food too. But this was just working. We're sleeping in tents, bathing in the creek, ice cold creek. But there's a camp there, like we was just like complete away from port life, and you're just like no electronics again because you're on a mission type deal. And there's a lake there, and you just like read your Bible, and you see like the birds going. You're just like depressing, even port life of. Then really being able to soak up God's word for the most part. I mean, it is hard to really get into Bible sometimes, but when you do, I forget what he told me there, but I probably wrote it down somewhere. Alright, yes. Yeah, all around this thing, we had to just chop it by hand. We had some meat ears, but that took 2 days of 25 people going crazy at it. Sorry. It was fun. We got to go swimming in there. Good time. This day we had a huge water balloon fight. Probably not the next couple of slides, but that's okay. We had a huge water balloon fight, and we're like, let's do something like a slip and slide or whatnot. And they're like, in this pit right here, is actually off of the obstacle course. After you get up, you have to go wallow in there and crawl through there. It's all timed. So that's just nasty, goopy, hot. Well, you don't know what's in there. But we put the slip and slide up, and we're like, let's run, we're running. And we're just flying in this pit of mud, dirt, water. I mean, it was great. It was really great. That's the fun aspects of working, because you work a lot, and you need get somewhere to kind of just depress from all the stuff that's going on, and you kind of just have fun at port. So I think it was 2,000 water balloon water fight. 2,000 water balloons. That was gone in like 10 minutes. We just, those things hurt. I had like welts. This is the fun side of working friendships. This is when I talked about the missions week. We had to set up a whole bunch of tents, and they have these cool military, actually anti-radar that like the army actually forgot, or they couldn't get it back, so they just left it like whole cases of just of that, and so it's actually real and it works. So we just have a whole bunch of that like scattered around, make it look really, but it's good for like the heat and shade wise, but otherwise it looks really cool too. And like I said before, we went to, we did a lot of ministry or outreaches, and we did like an outreach to the community of the projects in the neighborhood. Like there was a couple shootings there like a year ago and people died, so we went back into that neighborhood to put some light in there and it to go pray with people, but we have like the kids come out and to play with them and goof around painting the faces, and like that's what we do there. We kind of go in there and show people that like, you know, God is good, and even when there's something bad happening, we go in there and we try to really show that, be really like powerful to people and hand out food. And that's our main thing, is really just going into places there and affecting people, and those are fun times to play with the kids and all. Boot camp graduation! Got our dog tags. Oh, best thing to have. Says your name on it. Friendships. Yeah, four of us, you know, graduated. But yeah, that's us, and we finished. And it was like the opening speech, and it was like, well, no, welcome to the family. We're like, wait, we weren't your family? They're like, nope, now you are. Oh, living there for 3 months, and now you are. Oh, okay. This is our tactical our dress uniform that we wear when we go to church or we go to like something like a funeral or something like that. We all stand at attention. A few of you understand what that means. Attention, and you're dead eye forward, not moving at all. And for this particular occasion, we was after the state trooper Vincent, I think it was. Died, and we were at the memorial, and we were able to honor him by standing attention while they were going past, and it motivated people to come and stand by us and actually really, I mean, respect that. And that was a powerful moment for people driving by, and they told us that like the families really, really appreciated it, and like it meant a lot to them. So that was really, I mean, that was one of the best times we had there of doing that. All right, this is the Bow of the Integrity. It's one of the ships that we actually could go on the mission with, hopefully. It's a 182-foot refrigerated cargo ship, and just a great view of the sun, whatnot. Awesome. At an outreach, my lady had a couple kids and just passed around the baby taking pictures. She's like, oh, yeah, okay. Why not, right? But yeah, cute kid. Free time. Oh. We had a barbecue. And that was right after boot camp. No, it was free. And you can wear city clothes after you graduate boot camp. So she's like, oh, yes. The integrity itself. It's a pain because it's all rust. And that ship is just, I mean, it's full of rust, but you take your hammer, you take your needle gun, you go to town on it. And that's why I wear this is why I wear on a daily basis, but like with a shirt most of the time, because it's Louisiana, it's like 70 down there right now. But, We had a crew member come in with his family, and everybody came there to Friendships before, and he like motivated us and pushed us to finish the entire captain's deck and finish it all, go down to the bow and like finish paint it all. And now we're on the sides of the ship painting. We already got the starboard side like almost completely done, and as you can see, it looks a lot better than that stuff. But for me, I am a deckhand slash I got kind of an upgrade to engineer. So that was like, yes, I have to work on the deck all the time, and I can be in the engine room doing that and welding slash. So those are the benefits of learning. Also, during this prompt time, I could get my seaman license. So I mean, having that, and I can get my forklift license and get that. So I need to get that. But like serving God and also having the benefits of that and experience. And this is a lot of stuff that I'm doing, but also we do get the Bible a lot. I'll give you a quick sample day, so it's not just all work and stuff. But please, I'll give you the Seahawk one, not the boot camp version of daily. You wake up either 5:20 or 5:20 devotion or 6 o'clock devotion. I normally go to 6 o'clock, it's later. And you go there, you get up there. 4 or 6 o'clock, or you get a gig, So you're in there, you're reading your Bible for half an hour, or whatnot, and then you go down, you get a quick bite to eat, put your BDUs on, or your PT clothes on, shave up, brush your teeth, and then go up for morning refreshing. It's like a big corporate time, and all the big wigs come in, and we all have a devotion time of, we'll watch like a movie, which is really quite nice in the morning time. And we'll learn there and we'll have the daily announcements. So it's really nice to get that voice like, announcements. But then after that, we have a formation, morning formation. And during this time of CRX, you memorize the book of James.
Wow.
And you quote James chapter 1, Monday, chapter 2 on Tuesday, chapter 5 on Friday. Quote James 1, right after morning refreshing, you go down there, you get in formation, it's in there, it's like, we'll call it Fights and Quarrels, and you go down from there, and read it off, and I tell you, it can get a little boring after a while, but you kind of spice things up sometimes. But, I mean, that's what we do, and they check the shape and whatnot, and then we say that, tell us, and we go on for our day of work, either we go to PT, or you work on the ships, galley, or construction, but mostly it's all efforts are towards the ship. We go and work on the ship about 4 hours, come back, get some lunch. We have a lot of donated food because this ministry is all based on donations. We don't get any money. Everyone there, Seahawks, are all complete volunteer. No one in this ministry gets paid at all. That kind of blows some people's minds out here. Like, wait, so what are you going to do? Money up. God's got us. I mean, right before we left, we had a supplier give $30,000 plus of meat to us. I mean, like, we had 7 pallets full of just from ribeyes to lamb to seafood come in because they need to take it out for the new year coming in. So I mean, like we were praying for more food because we're getting low, and God supplied to us just at the right time. never
early,
you know. But that's like how God blesses us in the ways that if we ask for it, we'll receive it. There's a lot of things that go into James every time I think about this. We get a lot of donations, and that's how we survive. I mean, all the ships that are worth millions of dollars have been donated. Just, oh, here's it for free. Here's your integrity for free. Just take it. It's cool. I mean, thinking about it, it's like, this is millions and million dollar ship, which is given to people to do this kind of work, and it's, gotta think about it. It's weird. Huh. Sunset's really nice down there. Right on the river. It's called the Calcasieu River, also known as Calcapoo. Because you literally. That is not a real picture, but it is. It was enhanced. I was actually skipping rocks, so it's kind of cool. Oh. Sketchy rigging system. But. I mean, you're three scabs up on a barge. So, you know, we take our precautions, but not to that level. All right. I actually had a harness on it because I was feeling a little sketchy that day. But I just, we're working on the side of the ship, and up here is cool. That is the USS Orlick. It's a battleship, but it's like a laser tag, and museum will play laser tag. Someone like donates, like, hey, go play for free. Like, we're gonna go. We play on there, but it's like a cool battleship, and we normally have to tell people, like, you know, you ever heard of friendships? They're like, no, we're like, yeah, it's just upstream from the USS. Like, oh, really? Yeah, it's like those five ships just oh, that's cool. So that's normally a starter point. Starter point. Yeah. Oh boy, I'm on the Spirit on the outside on the weather deck, and that's what I pretty much see. Like, you see the bridge come on. That's where I first came here. I took a Greyhound, 20-something hours bus.
Very great.
Scary people.
Yeah. Yeah.
Greyhound. I tell you that because leaving my family, leaving like everything you know to go something you don't have a clue about, like really having to trust in God. Like, I remember I stepped on that bus, got in there, and I had no clue of what I was going to do. And I'm completely blank. Just now coming back, I mean, I'm filled up with motivation. I'm filled up with God, and my faith is my own. That's a big key point. And I'm motivated to work, and I'm, even though we don't get paid to work on the ship, I mean, I feel like the people at Seahawks who work on the ship, we work on it with just our utmost like power, going at it, working on the ship, trying to get everything done, and like, but we don't get paid, so it's like, We do it with like the utmost respect, and like, this is, I mean, it's called integrity, so you gotta have integrity. We're working on integrity. So it's, you know, that's kind of a normal joke that goes around.
Yeah.
Oh boy. This is a kind of better shot of the ships. And so I've got the Hope, that's a old Coast Guard building also in itself. This Divine Wind is an awesome 1935 sailboat. It was made for like the Queen of England. Donated. That's come a lot of money. There's no such thing as monies here. We had to move around the houseboat to try to get the barge out to work on the integrity. But it's a good amount. It's probably like half a mile long wise of just our own port life that really work on the stuff. That is a normal day of working on the deck, but with more like chips of paint on you. I mean, that's all rust, and yeah, gotta wear your glasses and safety gear things. That's me, Bradley, and Justin, and the deck crew working. It was just us three before the integrity had to go into missions mode. That's just us working, and we had fun. I don't know why, but working on the deck and chipping off rust and getting it all nice, like, oh, nice and smooth. And there's, he made a parable, off the parable of the sower with the rust, and that was funny.
Yeah.
Just us three working on there, just going to town. Yeah. Ah, this is what it's supposed to look like. Nice and shiny. I get the wire brush on there. Get that going. Oh, we get to, then we put some primer on and then we paint it later. But yeah. So we spend most of our time on the ship. But, yeah, that's another Seahawk. I mean, we go to town. That was getting the barge over there. I was not on the barge. It was yonder downstream. Kind of nice for me living down in Louisiana. You can see y'all and Howdy and all that stuff. I can, so it's nice. During my time here, we also got to do maritime classes and firefighting classes. And that's get the training, and it definitely kind of it almost made me want to become a volunteer firefighter in itself. We had to put it on by time, go down the engine room. That's this small little passageway. We had to carry up a person on a bodyboard. It was so bad, so heavy. No one passed out down there. That's the key point. Had my first amount of crawfish down south. Someone donated their like 55 gallon of like crawfish, and they boil it all down there. And I mean that was 3 pounds right there. I had about 6 pounds of crawfish. Like they just had buckets full. I mean, that was the first time of real boil crawfish. I mean, that was pretty yummy. I say.
That's it. The power print.
That it?
Nope.
Right, I'll go to the Bible. Those. Oh, that is. That's a vague amount of stuff that's happened. And, friendships, and we're the Seahawks. I don't know what my family is, what you guys heard about the Seahawks and what we do. But I'll give you a quick little thing about it, or I'll give my own understanding of it. Seahawks is a 1-year, 12-month program. 18 to 25-year-olds comes. If anybody wants to come. You serve a year of your life. I leave all you have, you go, and you work free, and you get so close to God, and you mature in your own way. I mean, if you don't want to do that, you know, don't come, but you learn, like, learn your own, you mature, and you learn self-discipline in a way that, like, you would after getting out of the military, in a way of being respectful and having that authority on you, and like just being able to live on your own and trusting God all the things you do, because without that they would not exist. And we're just the grunt workers of the mission, and we do new crazy stuff every day. Every day is subject to change. That's how I say it. Could be like working. Like, okay, we need to go to the food pantry and help upload 15,000 pounds of food. Okay, we do it. That's serving. Like the serving part is the best, because you're going to help someone, a local food pantry, unload a whole bunch of food, and you know, might not think about it, but like that goes out to the community that really actually needs it. You don't think about that because we're always trying to just working and stuff. But God really just makes that fun. I definitely say my walk with God, from the beginning I thought, you know, pretty good. I feel like I'm doing okay. And I go there and it's like, I don't really know anything. Oh, yeah, I read the Bible sometimes, but now it's like twice a day, and it's like, wow, how much I didn't read and I didn't understand. But now I understand, but I don't comprehend completely, but that I'm in the Word more, and that's like, wow, I didn't know I was that far behind in it. When you read the Bible and you earnestly seek it, Him, it's like He'll open Himself up and He'll find you. And we sing songs about that and stuff, so it's a explosion in my mind. But also becoming like a man during this time period of leaving my childish ways behind me, kind of just going out and becoming my own person and my own faith, and having the steadfast heart. I mean, that's the main thing of what we do. And I remember, it was, I think it was a couple days ago, I was in the bathroom, and I just, you know, like, I didn't think I read my Bible that day. And, you know, I felt weird. Like, if you don't go to church, you're kind of like, something's off today. I didn't read my Bible, and I was just like, there's no point to living unless God's in it.
Amen.
So, my roots are back at Port area to, like, help out there. You know, it's nice being here. But to serve down there is where God wants me right now. And friends are down there, and that's always a plus, too. Don't worry, Seth, I love you, too. And my friends, too. Definitely. One of my... After James chapter 4, it's like a Thursday probably. Boasting about tomorrow, I mean, it kind of. I'll read it. I can read it. Now listen, you say, today or tomorrow we'll go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business, make money. Why? You'll not even know what happened tomorrow. What is your life? You're a mist that appears for a little while and vanishes. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we'll live and do this or that. As it is, you boast and brag. If anyone knows the good you ought to do, doesn't do it, and sins. Oh, wait, no, almost. No, I got it. But, sometimes saying that, like, this one just always gets me, just like, you know, I'm going to do this tomorrow, but not asking God. It's like, is this what you want me to do? I mean, at least in my case, I kind of just went there and kind of worked out, but... But, like, living your life that way, is that what God wants me to do? Seeking the kingdom first, as we always seeking the kingdom, that's in the Bible, and it's like, should I do this? God, I mean, I know you're not going to give me a direct answer, but like, show me or something, and he will. I mean, and kind of, I love the, what is your life? You're a mist that appears for a little while. I mean, I'm gone 9.5 months, and it's like, oh. Just blanked and it was done. So it makes you think more so to live your life for God. And to really seek God first. Also, you know you should do good, and you don't do it, I mean, you're sinning. If you seek God, he'll open himself to you. And stepping on that bus and opening myself up, I found God in a new way of down south kind of spiritual stuff down there. Of going to all the different churches and hearing about, like, you know, Pentecostal people, charismatic, the supernatural side, and knowing that it's all good because it's all of God. And opening myself up to that and really getting that in a way, even though a few times, weird. But God is good and he's done work in my life. I'm not the same person I was when I left. And I'm glad. And it's really nice to be speaking here. I didn't think I was going to do too well or like to be.
Great.
But I actually got the time. Actually, I filled out the entire amount of time. Pardon me. It's pretty awesome. But, James is actually when I heard when I come in there, like, so yeah, we study a lot of James. I'm like, okay, read the Bible, get there. No, we memorize James. What? Oh. But this is, okay, I'll end with this because this is the boot camp of Seahawks and of Seahawk life, or end of any kind of life. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know it's the testing of your faith that develops perseverance. And you ask God for increased faith. You're going to get increased faith in ways that you didn't want, but... I mean, it's the testing of faith. that really increases your faith. That is probably everyone's main purpose when, or main struggle is the testing, and that's pretty awesome now. But yeah, I think that's about all they wrote, all I wrote so far.
Let it.